What is good, friends? More World Cup action. We have Praj Pran versus Vailusa, and this team, Praj Pran, has, it seems, pretty familiar. I've used the team with Dennis in a show on live, where it was 5 out of the 6 months. I think we had a Guavberry DD Zygarde over the Kyurem, and our team had a Rocky Helmet, Tangrowth, and a offensive Mijirna, Scarf Kellyu, Earthplate Landris. I could see this Mijirna being Assault Vest, to be honest, and the Kyurem being Z-move. But he could also be Shifty Mijirna, like, I'm not sure yet. Oh my lord, he Scarf Magina and he kills the land with Ice Beam on turn 2. How does he do it? Was this fast Lando and it was I think that was just max speed Magearna. That was weird. Like, I saw someone get bopped by Scarf Magearna on AIM's video. Like, he was trash talking CB and AIM, they were using Scarf Magearna and then he lost to it. But I don't think this is Scarf. That was just obviously a Rocks Landris on Vailusa's part, and they don't outrun Tyrant Magearna for sure, yeah. And yeah, this is, if this is Iceum Z, it might even Oko the Tangrowth. Yeah, I don't understand that play by Vailusa. I would have gone out either into Tangrowth or into my own Magearna there. Because, like, the set is not uncommon fast Maginas with Ice Beam these days. But yeah, Tangrowth was forced to click Earthquake here. I mean, I can try to look at Vailusa's team, but this, I feel like this game is already in Praj Pran's favor so much. Yeah, that's gonna Twit kill. And it's Shuku Magearna, wow. So yeah, that confirms pretty much, I think it's Z-move Kyurem Black, exactly. Really interesting set. I think what a genius in the chat. My man Colin has used this set like a few months ago in the ladder, I remember that. Yeah, Vailusa is either Scarf Zarya, Scarf Grin. It's kind of hard for me to, like, that's one thing I struggle with, like, if I just have team preview, there's like two potential Scarfers. I'm not super sure which one is the Scarfer. I'm leaning a little bit more towards Scarf Lari, and he just stays in. Yeah, this game is over. So I assume he's gonna be in range from Overheat. Not sure if he's in range from Flamethrower, but he's in range from Overheat for sure, I assume. And if he's AV Mijirna, like, he can either go to Kyurem if he has Roost. Or, like, he doesn't even have to be Roost, but Kyurem is a potential switch in here. Roost would just help with longevity, obviously. Like, he can either pivot from, yeah, okay, I was suggest saying that he could also potentially go Kaldio, but that play is unnecessarily risky. Overheat does a good chunk to the Kyurem, but he's just gonna click Sub-Zero Slammer and something is gonna explode, I think. Like, something is getting blown away. Like, Magearna is gonna take like 65 or something if it comes in a Sub-Zero Slammer. I saw that people stopped using Overheat Manek in 2014. But yeah, Overheat is not bad on Manek trick, like, it gets certain kills that Flamethrower doesn't kill. So Sedot said, for example, Bulu. And so does HP Poison. Okay, dude. HP Poison Manek trick, what is wrong with you? He's just kidding, probably. Obviously, I don't know why I said probably. Like, that is not a thing, don't make that a set. Yeah, he just goes for Sub-Zero Zoom, but this is Greninja Explode. This Greninja is... Oh, it lived. Yeah, it lived because of the Intimidate. I forgot the Intimidate from the Manectric. I was about to say this Greninja is gonna get Oko. That was minus one and it's still at 73. Sub-Zero Slam Akiyama is scary to switch into, good lord. But yeah, Prash Prawn is gonna go. I knew it's Tangrowth or Keldeo here. Gets up a spike, so it spikes Ashgren. Which, yeah, like I said, I was leaning a little bit more towards Scarflaaty. This kind of confirms Scarflaaty. I've actually seen a team like this on the ladder. I watched a Gambit video earlier, and like a team that looks like the losers. Maybe it was it was like one or two ones different. But I mean, that's a lot in this meta. So yeah, that's Scarf Keldeo, I think. Because the specs crit would have done more. Hello? You can't just say that. Imagine being down 2.5 months and setting spikes. This poor guy, hello? It's all good, it's all good. I'm glad that this game is kind of fast, because the last game I recorded about the Poik one, it was a CG Master. It was a really cool game, but I'm tired and it was like 35 or 37 minutes. And that stuff can get annoying. But I want to bring you guys as many games as possible, so you know. Okay, so he gets the match we're gonna knock off, which is a cool prediction. Is he still gonna overheat or, yeah, overheat kills the Kyurem exactly. So you can go to his own Manectric and Volt Switch here. The only way going to your own Manectric and Volt Switching would be bad is if you lose the speed time, potentially give the opponent momentum. But yeah, this is pretty much in Prash's favor. I can see him going Tangrowth and clicking. Yeah, okay, he decides to go in Manectric. I was just trying to see what was his best play, and I know. Oh yeah, he can, never mind. Like, Vilusa's never Volt Switching here because the Manectric can stay regular form. Do you click HP IC predicting the Lardy? I mean, does he lose anything from clicking T-Bolt? I think Prash can just click T-Bolt, right? If you get the HP eyes correct on Lardy, it's a nice stun, but overall T-Bolt should be fine here. Like, that's the option that he won't Mega Evolve, so this is tough over Lusa. He's minus 2, he can't really Volt Switch. In case he stays regular, so... I guess he's just gonna go into Magina or Latios. I assume the Magina is gonna be offensive, so that's not really a switch, and in case he goes for T-Bolt. So he's probably forced out into Lardy here, I assume, yeah. If he Volt Switches on the Lardy here, he looks like a complete overlord. And oh, if I lose a disconnected. Come back, my man. I'm hungry, dude, I gotta eat. Can you finish the game? Like, people need to stop. He said stop the timer. Oh yeah, he can't stop it. He's nice at least. But yeah, Prash Prawn is on Team Asia, by the way, if I didn't mention it yet. And Jim Peter has asked which team he is on, so if I got some time to mention that, let me... Why did Prash was muted? What the fuck? Was it because he's talking in all caps and spamming? Why is he getting so mad? Holy shit, calm down, dude. Prash is both an amazing player and a real gentleman. I actually played Prash on a ladder. He sent his team to TD. Oh god, he said he's not on. Ooh, this man is talking German. He should have not said this. This means something nasty. I know some people are gonna look this up on the Google Translator now. Oh god, my man, he's in the chat. I think Prash was using Scarf Hooper when I played him on ladder. It was definitely a fun game. It was a close one too, but I wasn't recording. Too sad I wasn't recording. Like, he was using SD Scully Pete. I think Baton Pass was still allowed at that time, but he was using the SD Scully Pete, not the Baton Pass one. With, like, Warrior Z, that's cool. It was used back a few months ago in SPL. Like, pretty much when Sun and Moon was still kinda new. But yeah, I'm gonna pause it until he comes back. So he comes back and he switches on to Latios, and I assume we see the Volt Switch exactly. Man, I wanted to say it before he made the play. Sorry, now I look like a young noob that just says the play after he made it. Yeah, he can go into Tangrowth here. And either click knockoff or earthquake, depending on what he wants to predict. But yeah, because Magina can come in on knockoff picking the Z move. But like, if you Praj, do you lose anything if the Magina comes out on the knockoff from the Tangrowth? Because you would still get off earthquake damage afterwards, and that should put the Magina in range from Scarf Keldeo. And I think I did the calc the other day, and if I recall correctly, Scarf Keldeo outspeeds Shift Gear Magina after Shift Gear. I really hope I remember that correct. Yeah, it's understandable that he took a while to make his play, so he decides to go in the Magina route. I didn't think every turn through, I just thought about the Tangrowth play at first. But yeah, the Magina play is probably the better play now that I look at this. But forgive me, guys, like, I'm literally on, like, no sleep to catch all them games for you. Like, I slept a little bit, but, like, it's, like, definitely not enough. But I'll be fine. I'll sleep a lot next night. Okay, so if he goes for Shift Gear here, does this just clean up? I mean, nah, the opposing Magina was too healthy. So he goes for Thunderbolt, knowing that Lari won't stay in because he probably can only touch it with Psy Shock. And Thunderbolt would do more than Ice Beam to this Magina, and would obviously do more than Greninja, so that's a nice play. So he goes into Manectric predicting another T-Bolt, as I assume that's in Power Fire. Oh, he has Shookaberry. Is he 3 attacks Shookaberry with Shift Gear, or is he just... is this just some 4 attack set? This is really interesting, I haven't seen this specific set before. I think T-Bolt hidden power. Yeah, I think that's in Power Fire, yeah, because HP Ground would have been super effective on Manectric, obviously. HP Fire is for Ferrothorn, because the Bolt Beam coverage would get walled by Ferrothorn, so that I can understand why you have that on this specific set. Like, you have a Sub-Zero Slammer Curum, which would do a lot to Ferrothorn, but yeah, Ferrothorn can still be really annoying, even though you have... like, you have some ways to kill it, you have a Manectric, you have... yeah, Keldeo is not the best answer, because Scarf Secret Sword doesn't do too much, especially if they run the Leech Seed Protect set. Ferrothorn can go from, like, a low health back to full health. But yeah, he did the sack of his Magina to the Overheat. Because, like, he didn't really have a good switch in, but now every time this goes for Overheat, it weakens itself, so, like, kind of gives something on Praj's team a free switch in. How healthy is the Lari? If the Lari was in Hydro Pump range, I would have gone into Keldeo and clicked Hydro Pump. Even though that can miss, I just like playing, like, if it's gonna kill, like, why not risk it? He goes Keldeo, I assume he's just gonna click Scald. I think Manectric should be in range of Scald. And he has the chance to burn the incoming Lari. Magina should get to it killed, I think. Let me open my window, it's a bit hot in here. Even though it's already, like, evening. I had my window, like, closed, so he did decide to go into Greninja and he Secret Sorted. Secret Sword is a little bit more to Lari than Scald, because Lari has some better speed def than fist def. And maybe Secret Sword would have done more to Manectric, not really sure. How healthy is the Tangrowth? I mean, Tangrowth is nice this game. I don't think you want to hard switch in. Pretty sure that the Latias is gonna go for Psyshock here. Yeah, the sun was basically shining in my room all day. If I didn't, it was just. I don't know if I finished a sentence that I started like a minute ago, a few seconds ago. Like, I'm that tired. I don't even remember which was my last sentence. Oh, BGB asking, what is the min win loss to qualify? Sometimes it's 15-15, as League's saying, but it's unlikely. I mean, I assume, okay, Finch said 16-14 is fine. I think, how many teams move on to the next round? He Dracos instead of Psyshock. I think Psyshock would have been fine. Am I missing something here? I'm probably missing something. I think 8 teams move on to World Cup next round, right? But I'm not sure. But this is at -2 now. Yeah, this is the only potential rocker. He did show Z-move already. Like I said, this... Actually, I don't know if I talked about the Landorus set at all. But I could see this being Earthplayed. Because I said I had a team pretty similar to this and it was Earthblood Landris. And just in general, he already has 1,000 arrows switching and Tangrowth. So it doesn't necessarily have to be defensive Landris. It would still help with stuff like switching to stuff like Morwall and Marowak. But like he can also play aggressive versus those, make aggressive doubles, play pressure. But he goes for knockoff. So is this a Scarf? No, wait, this is probably to get rid of the, this is probably to help versus the stall matchup, yeah. So to get rid of the Evilite from Chansey, for example. What else? Like, for a second I thought it was Scarf Lando, but I think it's just offensive Lando, because this is his only potential rocker, right? I'm not tripping. Yeah, this is his only potential rocker. So knock off Stealth Rock, Earthquake. And either HP Ice or you do, and I assume HP Ice? Well, I'm not sure. And he's Yachty Berry, wow. So that answers my question if he was Earthplay. So it's basically defensive, like a bulkier. Was it a bulky lander? No, I think it's offensive landers. It was an offensive lander, it just ate it up because of Yachty Berry. Because a max HP landers, I think. You only need a little bit of Spadef investment and you always live guaranteed live HP Ice from full. Which means with Yachty Berry, if you max HP Landorus with a little bit of Spadef investment, this should have done around 45-50%, like 45-48%, but it shouldn't have done 56%, so there's some more offensive Landorus. Maybe there's a little bit of HP investment. And yeah, this game actually became a little closer than I thought. But I think Prashpon still has it. Which team is Vailuza on, by the way? I'm not sure. Oh, I think he's on Brazil. I'm not 100% sure. I think I've heard he's Brazilian. Or was it Portuguese? No, I think he's Brazilian. Yeah, they're talking about Vailuza's mid-journey item. I'm pretty sure it's Z-move. It's not revealed yet, yeah. It would be really nice if there was no game after this. Like, there was literally like 3 or 4 games, game after game after game after game. Like, I enjoy doing this, but like, I've said that multiple times, right? I said it in an Ogre video for sure, I don't know how often I said it overall. Yeah, sometimes I like mess up a narration when I'm too tired, or like I have my microphone on mute and I have to redo it, which is like really, really... it's not fun. I had to redo the Pearl game earlier. But he's gonna click Draco or Sideshow. Okay, I got everything wrong earlier. Earlier when I thought he should have Sideshowed the Draco, then now when I thought he Draco, he clicked Sideshow. I don't think it made a huge difference, like... Because if he Dragos, he goes to -2, Tangles with the next Draco. And if he Sideshows, it doesn't tweet Q anyway. So he gets in the Mijuna. Z-move is confirmed, no item gets knocked. So that, so Dirt said EQ into Scald kills, ghosting the chat. He's watch him get banned from lobby. Yeah, thanks for... Actually, yeah, I should be in call with some guys to help me out. But that was like... The thing is, I didn't want to miss any turns. And I didn't want my risking that I would lag. Because I remember like yesterday I was lagging that one game. We are literally giving Rune Pass and shit now. Zamrock says, don't say Zeds and Battle Upset, of course. Of course, Battle Upset, show me Shift, give me Juna, please. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's that Zed. I mean, it could still be Trick Room, but. I think it's Shift Gear. But yeah, since Scarf Keldeo still outspeeds that, unless I fucked up my, like, unless I forgot, remember that wrong. Like, I'm pretty sure I called, like, a week ago or so, in a video where it was Shift Gear Mijuna was killed and outsped. So yeah, like Siddharth said in the chat, Earthquake into Thing kills the things. What if this goes for Z-move here? This goes for Z-move here, the Tangrowth dies. And then if Landorus comes out, it might be a 50-50 between Vylusa going Lardian staying in. So this game is actually kind of gone down a bit closer than I thought. Because like, if you stay in the Tangrowth here and lose it to a Z-move, it could be bad. So I gotta understand that they're taking their time on this specific turn. I mean, ever since Vylusa had the seed and came back, I think he... Yeah, it's been taking really long, but it's fine. This is a 50-50. Love to smoke this shit. Why did Padlock leave? Hello? Did he get banned from smoke shooters? He didn't. Okay, it's not Vylusa taking the turn, never mind. I can literally fall asleep if I would close my eyes right now, like it wouldn't take too long. Ghost and Landorus, there's the Shift Gear and Ice Beam is gonna come out. Mijuna can actually win this still. Goes into Keldeo breaking the Ice Beam, nice play. Oh, he freezes, but Scaldwood saw him. Scaldwood saw him. It's fine. It's fine. Chill. The thing is, I don't know if Hydro Bomb had a chance to kill. But if Hydro Bomb had a chance to kill, it freezes. It sucks. But I think Hydro Bomb wouldn't have killed. Because it's just a Scarf kill, you know, a Specs kill, you right? It's not that strong. The thing is here, if he goes for Scald and then Mijuna kills the Keldeo, he's gonna get a Soul Heart boost. And he might just win from there, because... Tangrowth should die to whatever Z-move he has. And might even die to Ice Beam after Spikes, because it's a +1 Ice Beam after he kills the Keldeo from Praja's side. It does 52 to 62. Wow, so if he gets max, if he gets absolute max damage, this has a chance to kill. I mean, he's not gonna get absolute max damage, I don't think so. Goes back into Tengris predicting the Thunderbolt. So that was interesting. Oh wow, that was played pretty well. Did he get frozen again? Phew. So Earthquake brings this into Skull range. Yep, Prush played nice around this, but oh my lord. Sex of the Landers basically. Goes into Keldeo, clicks Secret Sword of Skull here. Yeah, he has to click Skull to saw himself, what am I saying? And Scarf Lottie might actually pick up the win for Wailusa. Nah, I think knockoff kills. Yeah, knockoff from Tengris kills. Yeah, as long as there's no crit, knockoff from Keldeo still kills. But this game came down way closer than I anticipated. No crit knockoff should kill, and GG Prash Pandrins. Narrow 1-0 victory for Asia. Oh my lord, stop going insane. I know Ipro's playing later, or else. Please give me a break. No more games now. Wailusa said he choked, but I'm not gonna get into that. I can't really, like, what's the correct term? I can't really. Oh yeah, shout out to my subscriber that PM'd me. But yeah, I didn't respond to you if you see watching this because I record 4 games in a row. I can't really tell if he choked. If he had Z move with Magina, why didn't he go for it for the Tangros? Maybe he was Giga Volt Havoc. I'm not really sure. But yeah, cool game. I don't know how many games Asia has played. I recorded the 2 analytic games and this Prashpron game, so I think those 3 games make Asia 2-1 at the moment, but they probably played more games that I can't think about from the top of my head. But yeah, I think this was Prash's first game. And also Wailusa's first game. I hope you guys all enjoyed. Searching for more content and goodbye. I'll have way more World Cup coming. I'm wild. Zamrog is playing Soul Gaze. What is that for? It's probably just a friendly, right? Peace out, friends. Goodbye.